guys. My name is Sean Nelson, and I am the owner of Kiyoshi Poetry, and I write poems, and I want to share them with you guys in the ASMR style. I don't know if this will work, but I'm going to have relaxing stuff playing in the background, and I don't exactly have a great video recorder yet, so we're just gonna go with this. But anyway, as I said, my name is Sean Nelson. I own Kiyoshi Poetry. You can find me on allpoetry.com/Kiyoshi Poetry. I'm also on, I've got a Gmail, a YouTube channel, and what else do I have? I've got a bunch of stuff. I've got products available for sale on Zazzle.com. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this, and let's get going. Let's get started. Okay. So, the first one I'm going to read to you is The 12 Haikus of Christmas. I like to write poetry that's really funny, and I like to write serious poetry too. So I'm going to start off with stuff that's really funny. I know this is ASMR and you want to go to sleep, but maybe comedy might help you go to sleep. So anyway, let's get started. The 12 Haikus of Christmas. If you don't know what a haiku is, it's 5 syllables on the first line, 7 syllables on the second line, and then 5 again. So it's 5-7-5, so let's get going. Out Christmas shopping, hectic hallways of holly, I barfed on Santa, oh boy. Going caroling, singing with laughter and joy, I forgot a verse. Time to decorate, I can't find all the pieces, time to buy new ones. Yes, it's unfortunate. Opening presents, I got all that I wanted. I am so not spoiled. Cooking is easy. I burnt the Christmas dinner. It's time for Denny's. My mom really liked that one. And it reminded me of the movie The Santa Claus. Have you ever seen that? It's one of my favorite movies for Christmas time. With Tim Allen. He's such a great actor. I watch every single one of Tim Allen's shows. What was his first one? Tim the Toolman Taylor. Home Improvement, that's what it was. I really like that show. And there's another one that came out. It's a newer one. He's got girls instead. So, yeah, I really like both of his shows. And he was also in another movie. He gets, I don't know, it's got Sigourney Weaver in it. And that guy from, you might know what I'm talking about, you might not. Anyway, so let's continue. What's under the Christmas tree? No, what's under the tree? It's almost Christmas. Can't sleep. Can I take a peek? Happy holidays. Political correctness. It's Merry Christmas. That's one of my mom's favorite too. Flying for Christmas? Don't waste your money on planes. Just go find Rudolph. Here comes Santa Claus. How could he not be bankrupt? Magic money trees. Rudolph lights the way. Nuclear power plants near. Is that what happened? Because you don't know. You don't know how his nose got red and it's glowing? How could it not be something that's nuclear and radiation and all that? Okay, went for a sleigh ride. Nothing funny about that. You know, if you're riding in Santa's sleigh all the time, you're doing riding and riding and riding all the time, but you gotta think that he gets hit by some poop from those deer's butts. So, this one this next one has been, sorry about that. I've got the idea from Christmas vacation. Outdoor light setup. A little knot, my dad says. This could take me weeks. So let's see what I've got so far. I've got about 6 minutes going in here. Yeah, let's keep going. This one is called Poker Dogs. I played a card game with dogs the other day. I lost, but had no dog biscuits to pay. Boy, it really got those dogs barking. Pretty soon, it's my leg they'll be marking. I think that one's pretty funny. Oh yeah, don't you dare stare there to the far off distance while facing the sun. You don't want to do that. You don't look into the distance and face the sun while you're doing it. I may have done this one already. This one's funny. It's called Crazy Fishes. My little fishes think they can get through the glass. Hope they don't share that thought with the bass. Yet now you see my fish tank is shattered. And the fish, by golly, are all bruised and battered. I hope they don't need the Porcelain Express. I'll have to take them to the vet, I guess. Yeah, I don't even know if people take fishes to the vet at all. They might not, I don't know. You know, fishes don't really have this thing about living unless they're in the water. So, well, this one's called The Timely Sneeze. You know, it was pretty funny in my head, but I don't exactly know if people really enjoyed it. This guy says this has no imagery or anything too real. Get a sense of escapism of, that's what he says. So what I put is, ever wonder what it was like to slow the flow of time, then to cover the entire world with booger-colored slime? Then you could pretend to sneeze when you started again. People everywhere would always think that you've gone insane, or they've gone insane, that's what I meant to say. It's quite an interesting concept, you know. You sneeze and then you pour booger-colored stuff all over the world. And then, slow time. Okay, I'm pretty sleepy. I should be doing this video a bit later, but you know, I'm just gonna have fun with it. Pain isn't fun, you know. Once you've had it, just try asking Bugs the cartoon. Hard to go to bed. I've got way too many hats on my head. It's gotta be real hard to go to bed. Did you hear what I just said? Oops, I'm naked and your face is red. Oh yeah, this one. It's gonna keep you awake. It's gonna make you laugh, I think, at least. It's called Rocket Poo. I'm on the toilet with an empty laxative in my pocket, but I'm afraid it will make my poop like a rocket. More loud sounds and a ton of falling boulders. Let's hope I can keep my head on my shoulders. Yeah, this is definitely random. And the guy who replied to mine said, better to have rocket-propelled poo than a boulder stone poo in your rectum, I guarantee it. So go on, be brave, pull that empty laxative from your pocket and swallow it. Oh yeah, yeah, well definitely, you have to do that. You gotta take that stuff because, jeez. It's horrible having your intestines full of poop. I'm the one to know, because it's happening to me. So I'm hoping, you know, giving you guys this poetry can help me out with my body and help me make more money, because I'm pretty poor and stuff, so, you know. Anyway, I'm going to end this video at 10 minutes, and I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and have great sleep. I hope this helped you go to sleep. See you guys later. Have fun. Bye-bye.